As expected, the worst sales data came through. Factory data also plummeted. The Fed is now concerned about the major downward trend that is present and could easily set off a new 1930s breakdown. The deficit spending is historic, and the debt has added up to levels never seen in history. But nobody really cares anyway, since ignoring reality is so trendy these days. Well, I'm glad you came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today we are going to look at a healthy dose of reality. It's important to see what's coming through every single day, track and trace all of the information, condense it down, learn as much as we can so that we can be prepared. We can make really good choices if we have the knowledge. If we are ignorant of it, we are never going to be ahead of the game. I've got some information today. We're going to talk about what's happening in the economy. I'm going to show you everything you need to know. Let's begin. Retail sales plunge a record 16.4% in April, far worse than predicted. They had predicted 12.3%, 16.4%. It's all about expectations as far as we know every time around. They usually do it the other way around, whereas they would have been expecting that 16.4%, and then they say, well, it was only 12.3%, so everything is just fine. This is actually worse. Now, when you look at what has happened here, people have basically contracted. They were spending initially in March. They were going out and buying provisions and toilet paper and whatever else that they needed. But now they're in a contraction mode because they're unsure. They're uncertain. What's going to happen to my job? What's going to happen to my family? I don't know. So I'm just going to wait it out and see. A lot of the sales and different things that people would have wanted to buy before are not doing so now. Of course, we've seen different industries, whether it's the airlines and cruise lines and anything to do with travel and other industries that have basically been decimated. Restaurants, which is one that I'll talk about today, has really taken a hit. And nobody expected this kind of thing to happen. But of course, you need to hope for the best while you prepare for the worst. That's always the smartest decision. Now, that doesn't equate to the highest profits. But certainly, when times get tough, you're not going to be in that position that so many others are. All of the biggest investors, when you look at what they do, not throughout one cycle, but you see over their career, they are the ones that say, don't lose money. When you see their portfolio, maybe it didn't beat the market, or maybe it did beat it, but in a small percentage when you look at it compared to a handful of stocks, the FANG stocks. Okay, they didn't perform that well. But look at what happens during a crisis. A lot of times we see that they're able to maintain some strength, whereas hedge funds, average investors, they get destroyed. Look at the pension funds. So underfunded after an 11-year bull market, and now particularly with Illinois, for example, there's no turning that back. Damage was felt across the board, with closing stores faring worst and grocers showing the only gains. I'll give you some data on that here. Record drop in retail sales, advanced retail and food service sales, percentage change from the prior month. We've never seen anything like this. If you look at what happened during the financial crisis, of course it did dip down as people were wondering what's going to happen, what's going on, but it is nothing like we're seeing today. Retail store sales by category. This is all broken down, and you could see the non-store retailers, which is basically online sales, is positive 8.4% as everybody went online to start buying things. Sales on Amazon, of course, had drastically increased, but look at everything else. Clothing and accessories, minus 79%. It is unprecedented, to say the least. Look at all the other numbers as well on here. You could see how they break it down. If you're interested in this or any of the others that I'll show you today, I'm not going to read everything to you, but of course it's all there if you want to check it out. Link will be in the description. U.S. factory production plummets by most in records to 1919. I didn't realize it was this bad, but as you can see, very clearly, output slumping 13.7% from the prior month, and we don't even know what's going to happen when we get the newest data that comes out. Of course, this certainly could be a factor where some of these places have opened up, and we start to see that bottom that comes in here, but how long does it take for everything to come back up? Many people have said years, depending on the industry. Now, this is really shocking. One quarter of American restaurants won't reopen. That's according to Open Table. And they're actually a good source for this information. It's not conclusive. It's not that is the end all be all. But I like it because it's a lot of different restaurants altogether. Their data has been really highlighting what's been happening all throughout this process. And I think at least in this limited view, we're able to get some good information from what they provide. Nationwide reservations are still down 95% from a year ago. One in every four US restaurants will go out of business. So the way I look at this is that yes, we have this one in four. Okay, very important to look at that 25%, depending how you like it better in percentages or numbers. We have to think of the individual because the individual that works at this place or owns this place is going to be affected. Maybe they are going to have to be laid off. Maybe the businesses themselves will have to shut down. This will impact people on different levels. But what's important to note is that this spreads. So of course, then if this individual is laid off, then what do? They have to collect unemployment. Maybe they have to sell the place that they currently live in. They can no longer afford their housing. They go back to the landlord. They say, I can't pay for my rent because of this or that. The landlord then starts taking a hit. They have to go out and maybe they're getting a loan now as a result because three out of their 10 units can't pay rent for the next 2 months. This individual also isn't going to the movies. He's not going to other restaurants himself. He's not doing anything else. So the economy in general is slowing down because of this group of people. If they don't have the income or at least what they did have before, they're not going to be able to spend it. And even if they did have the money, as we can see, we are contracting right now. This is a contracting phase for a lot of people. I showed you previously, I think it was the last video I did, people that are making $40,000 or less. 40% of those people were laid off, or more specifically, fired. So this represents a pretty significant percentage of the population in total. And I've got some serious problems with this because when you look at how this is affecting each other, when you spend a moment, just take a moment for yourself and think about all the connections, all the dots that connect and how that makes up to the economy as a whole, it starts to become really shocking. This article here is talking about JCPenney, and I wanted to bring it to you, and I thought it was just one example of what's been happening with so many other companies similar to it, as well as in other industries. In March and April, retail sales in the US saw the worst two-month decline in history. The retail apocalypse has pushed a slew of iconic American retailers to the brink of bankruptcy. When I talk about this, I am reading you information from different websites. I quote that. I use their lines in many cases. And so many people, they don't want to hear it. They talk about it's pessimistic, it's negative. Well, look, all I'm doing is condensing the information. You have to do what you want with it. But the good news here is that the executives, four top executives, receive millions of dollars in bonuses. And that's really what it comes down to. I'm really glad that millions of dollars went the way of the executives. And you would think, well, it's JCPenney. JCPenney's a bad company for this and for that. And that's why they're out of business. Oh, no. It's not that company. It's Wells Fargo. Wells Fargo is the problem. They gave bonuses. They're bad. No, they're all doing the same thing. And I assure you, those at the top, no matter what industry, no matter what company, they do not have the interests in mind of everybody else. Those at the top worry about those at the top. And just so happens that those at the top of the pyramid have friends in the other pyramids right at the top, and they are all colluding together. But people can't make these connections because they're focused on PE ratios and moving averages, and they don't see the big picture. But if you're here watching this video right now, listening to me right now, 99% chance you actually care about the truth. And that is so amazing to me. Thank you very much. estimated change in monthly sales for retail and food services by kind of business. So you can look at the breakdown that they have right here. And just to give you a little idea of the non-store retailers, it's just showing you 8.4%. Everything else was destroyed, as you can see. This is the chart that corresponds to that. Non-store retailers is the green line. And of course, that has expanded. It has been expanding over the years. But right now, we saw that big spike upward. Motor vehicle and part dealers has been just pummeled. You could see it on the right-hand side, the yellow line. This was largely expected, of course, because of what's been happening. And I don't see the trend really getting any better in the short period, despite some others that say everything is totally fine. Cass Freight Index, you look at the shipments and you could see here what has been going on. It's not very good either. They're calling the bottom here and saying that, well, oh, don't worry, everything's going to be okay. But just take a look at what this looks like. I want to point something out. Yes, we have seen this major decline just like all the other stats. But as I've noted so many times before, especially in recent weeks, we had this declining from 2018. The peak here is 2018. If you can't see that on the chart, this has been going downward. It's a trend. It was already on that trend. The economy has been weakening for a while. And what is going on here? You cannot pump this up forever. You have to allow it to cleanse. The economic detox that I talked about in my first book, it's so apparent right now why we need that. And of course, they didn't allow that to happen at all. Big mistake. Cass Freight Index shipment volumes. I know you know which one is 2020. It has simply fallen off a cliff as we have expected. We'll see what happens with this V-shaped recovery that will never happen. And yet we'll look back on this 10 years down the road and they will refer to a V-shaped recovery even though it never happened. The Cass Truckload Line Haul Index falls further, goes back to global financial crisis levels. No matter what kind of data we're looking at here, it's just going from bad to worse. This article here is something that I think people should spend a few minutes reading through. I'm not going to get into it all, but I just wanted to touch on it because it is really important. And it's just one example, or actually a few examples of what's happening, but we know this is widespread. Stealth bailout shovels millions of dollars to oil companies. Check this out. As it headed towards bankruptcy, Diamond Offshore Drilling Inc. took advantage of a little notice provision in the stimulus bill Congress passed to get a $9.7 million tax refund. Then it asked a bankruptcy judge to authorize the same amount as bonuses to 9 executives. Isn't that fantastic? The top of the pyramid seems to be winning yet again. But all people are focused on is the circus that's going on. This guy's yelling at that guy. This person's yelling over there. They're distracting you. They continuously distract you so that you can't see what's actually happening. You look at it as one piece of data. This article here is one piece of information. There's so much more in here. I'm not going to bore you with all the details, but look into the other pieces. And then you start to connect them together and you realize, wait a minute, these are not separate events. This is happening on purpose. But for the few who have actually stayed with me to hear the mad scientist that is the Money GPS and what I have to say, you know what's going on. None of that garbage that happens in the news is going to sway you in one direction because you realize what's actually going on behind the curtain. It's so amazing to have really good subscribers and it helps me to make these videos every single day. I try to bring as much content as I can that is full of information. I don't go into all this political nonsense. I don't talk about some of the things that people that used to cover the information that I'm still covering today have gone off into left field. I don't know what the hell it's all about. Not interested. When you're on this channel, you just get the data. Everything is always sourced in the description, and that's the end of that. If you found the video informative, hit that thumbs up button. When you do, you're supporting me. Thank you. If you want to check me out on Instagram, on Twitter, check me out at The Money GPS. And if you want to sell online, now is the best time to learn. If you haven't learned already, I created a free e-course. Unlike all those others that charge you $1,000 plus, this one is free. TheAmazonGPS.com. My two books break down everything. In the first one, I talked about the economic detox. And if you look at the second book, of course, it fits into it like a lock and key. It's important to understand what the central banks are doing and how the economy is really built. These two books give you everything you need to know. There's a link in the description if you want the audiobook, themoneygps.com. Wait a second, don't go anywhere. Have you seen this video? It's so important and not enough people have watched it. So if you have the time, click on it. I'll see you there.